Dear students, today we are going to summarize the natural resources that is the best gift nature has ever given to the mankind. In this unit, we will learn about the natural resources, problems associated to natural resources, various types of resources like forest resources, water resources, food resources, impact of the modern agriculture, and renewable and non-renewable energy resources. So let us revise this unit with the important terms. So various important terms in this unit are afforestation, that is growing or cultivation of new trees in new areas. Then biomass energy, it is energy obtained from the living biomass, that is living organic matter. Conservation, it is judicious or efficient use of natural resources. Deforestation, it is cutting down of the trees for the commercial activities. Desertification, conversion of fertile land into barren land by various activities. Then fossil fuels, the fuels which we obtain in the form of fossils like coal, oil and natural gas. Non-renewable resources, those resources which cannot be regenerated immediately or they cannot be replenished immediately, for example, coal, oil and natural gas. Overgrazing, that is overutilization of the resources or overutilization of the grasses. Renewable resources, the resources which can be regenerated or can be replenished, for example, solar energy, ocean energy, forest resources, etc. So few important abbreviations in this unit are CFL, that is compact fluorescent lamp, CNG, compressed natural gas, LED, light emitting diode, LPG, liquefied petroleum gas, OTEC, ocean thermal energy conversion, PIL, public interest litigation, SNG, synthetic natural gas. So let us do some multiple choice questions from this unit. What is the ideal requirement of forest cover in India? 23%, 55%, 33%, 40%. The correct answer is 33% forest cover is required according to the size of the population of the India. What is the total percentage of water on the earth? 70%, 71%, 80%, 65%. The correct option is 71%. Water is present on the surface of earth. Which of the following are non-renewable resource of energy? Coal, water, forest, wildlife. Coal is the non-renewable resource of energy. What is the full form of OTEC? Ocean thermal energy conversion, ocean thermal energy conservation, ocean thermal energy consumption, of thermal energy conversion. The correct answer is ocean thermal energy conversion. What is the full form of CNG? That is compressed natural gas, compressed nature gas, cyclic natural gas, chlorinated natural gas. The correct answer is compressed natural gas. So dear students, such multiple choice questions can be asked from this unit, that is natural resources. Now we may have some short answer type questions also from this unit. Supposing, what do you mean by natural resources? So we will give the paragraph, those resources which can be obtained from the nature or which are blessed to the mankind by the nature are known as natural resources. Natural resources can be air, water, soil, etc. These resources, they are divided into different kinds. That is, classification of natural resources can be written in this. We can classify the natural resources on the basis of chemical nature, on the basis of distribution, or on the basis of degradation. So we can have different types of the natural resources like organic natural resources, inorganic natural resources and mixed natural resources. They can be national resources, multinational resources or international resources. They can be biodegradable resources and non-biodegradable resources. Then we will give the concluding paragraph that they are of great value to the mankind. Then question number 2, classify different types of natural resources. As I have discussed just now, that in the question number 1, we will write natural resources are the resources which can be obtained from the nature. They can be classified into different groups on the basis of the chemical nature, on the basis of distribution, and on the basis of degradation or decomposition. So these can be classified into further different groups, that is, on the basis of chemical nature, natural resources can be of 3 types: organic natural resources, inorganic natural resources, mixed natural resources. Whereas on the basis of distribution, natural resources are of 3 types: national natural resources, which are property of one particular nation; multinational natural resources, resources which are shared by 2 or more than 2 nations, example rivers; international natural resources, the resources which are shared by all the nations, for example air is international resource. On the basis of availability, natural resources are of 2 types, that is, inexhaustible natural resources and exhaustible natural resources. So resources which are available in abundance, they are unlimited, like air, water, etc., they are known as inexhaustible natural resources, whereas exhaustible natural resources are which get exhausted with the passage of time. Their quantity is limited, their availability is limited, for example forest resources. But these exhaustible resources can be classified into renewable and non-renewable natural resources. So the resources which get regenerated with the passage of time, they are known as renewable natural resources, whereas non-renewable natural resources are the resources which get renewed or which cannot be regenerated immediately in the nature, for example fossil fuels. So we can classify the natural resources like this. Question number 3, explain the fertilizer pesticide problem. So fertilizer pesticide problem is a very important issue related to the agriculture sector. So in this question we will discuss what are the chemical fertilizers, chemical pesticides, what are the harmful effects of the fertilizers or the pesticides. In this way we will discuss the impact of fertilizer pesticides on the agriculture sector and such harmful effects. They are leading to the food crisis and are further they are declining the food production also. So you can say we will discuss in detail the story of the crops of the Punjab and impact of the modern agriculture, that chemical fertilizers, they have almost altered the chemistry of the soil. Toxic pesticides, they have made the soil poisonous to such an extent that it has entered into the food chain and it has undergone biological magnification, and it is leading number of problems to the human health also. So fertilizer pesticide problem has to be dealt seriously. Then write a short note on forest resources. Forest resources are the resources which are source of wood and wood products. Besides this, forest resources are playing very, very important role. So first of all, we will discuss the present scenario of the forest resources. Then we can discuss about the uses of the forest resources. The different uses of the forest resources are, they are source of the wood and they are the source of the shelter to the wild plants and animals. They are source of the beverages, they are source of tea and coffee, they provide shelter to many wild animals, they are the only source which provide us oxygen, they provide the wood for the furniture industry, they provide raw material for the paper industry. So you will mention almost all the uses of the forest resources and ultimately you will conclude that cutting down of the forest resources leads to many harmful effects. And we must conserve the forest resources by the rotational cutting pattern. Then write a short on the mineral resources. Mineral resources are the resources which are source of various metals and non-metals in the form of the minerals. So here we will mention about the mineral resources are extracted by a process known as mining. You will mention steps of the mining, that it includes prospectation, then exploration, development, exploitation, or harmful effects of the mining on the forest resources can also be mentioned. But the uses of the various metals and non-metals can also be mentioned. But ultimately, minerals are the economy of any nation. We must use the mineral resources in a very, very wise manner so that harmful effects of the mining can be reduced. So such kind of the short questions answers will be asked from this unit. The long question answers. In this, first question is explain renewable sources of energy. So renewable term means the resources of the energy which can be regenerated again and again. They are known as renewable resources of energy. In this, we will mention different types of the renewable energy resources, like number one, hydroelectric power. Hydroelectric power is the energy obtained from the water with the help of dams. It plays very important role. It doesn't cause any pollution. It is the renewable resource of energy. It is very convenient to use, but there are certain limitations of the hydroelectric power which has led to the solar energy. So solar energy is the energy obtained from the sun. Again, it is a renewable source of energy, and in India it is having very wide scope. It does not cause any pollution. It can be used to prepare the solar cookers, solar heaters, solar calculator, even solar vehicles are available nowadays. And there are certain limitations of the solar energy. So we have next option is biomass energy. That is energy obtained from the biomass, or the organic matter is known as biomass energy. Biogas can also be obtained from the different organic matters. We can have biopetrol, biodiesel. It is of great importance in the scenario of Indian situations. Then wind energy, it is the energy obtained from the wind. It can be obtained from the places where strong currents of the winds are available. Then ocean energy can be very useful in the coastal areas. So energy obtained from the ocean is known as ocean energy, that is obtained from through OTEC, that is Ocean Thermal Energy Conversion System. So this energy plays very important role to understand the or to supplement the energy crisis in the coastal areas, particularly metropolitan cities near the coastal areas. So it is again pollution free and renewable source of the energy. Besides this, we can have geothermal energy, that is energy obtained from the hot water springs which are present below the earth. Then tidal energy, energy obtained from the different tides of the water. And alternative source of energy like hydrogen, then alcohol, or the fuel cells can also be another option. So in the renewable energy resources, we will discuss almost all the renewable resources along with limitations and their advantages. Whereas question number two, non-renewable resources of energy, it will include the resources of energy which cannot be regenerated immediately. They include basic fossil fuels, that is coal, oil, and natural gas. You will explain in this the advantages of the coal and its limitations, present scenario of the coal, that coal is very bulky in size, it is very difficult to transport, it causes production of the unburnt carbon particles, so it is source of pollution. So due to these limitations, there was discovery of the next fuel, that is oil or petroleum. So it is again very important liquid fossil fuel. The crude oil or the petroleum can be undergone distillation, fractional distillation. We can have number of byproducts like petrol, diesel, liquefied petroleum gas, kerosene oil, and the wax from this. So oil is really wonderful fuel for the transport vehicles. It is very efficient than the coal. It is very easy to transport. It is convenient to use. It is cleaner fuel than the coal. LPG can be used for the cooking, but unfortunately, again, this fuel is not present in abundant reserves in India as well as in the world. So the natural gas was the another option for the mankind. So it is a gaseous fossil fuel. It is mixture of methane, propane and the ethane. Natural gas is cleaner and efficient fuel than the coal and the oil. It causes very less pollution. It can be easily compressed into CNG, which can be used to run the vehicles, and it can reduce the pollution to great extent. It can also be used as industrial raw materials, but natural gas reserves are also limited. But you have to say non-renewable energy resources are limited. They must be used very wisely, and there is need to explore the renewable energy resources. Then question number 3, describe the use and overuse of forest resources. In this, firstly, we will mention present scenario of the forest resources, that we are having almost 33% of the area should be under forest cover. But at present, we are having only 11% of the forest cover under the cultivation. So there is wide gap of 22%. There is need to grow more and more forest resources. So we will firstly mention the uses of forest resources, that forests play a very important role to provide the shelter to the wild animals. It helps to prevent the natural disasters. It is the only source of oxygen. It absorbs the CO2 and reduces the global warming. It provides the organic matter, make the soil fertile. It provides shelter to the wildlife, wild plants. It brings rainfall. It maintains water cycle. It brings ecological balance. So you will mention all the uses. But overuse of the forest resources means we are cutting beyond the cultivation. So over-exploitation of the forest resources is due to deforestation. So it means when rate of cutting down of the trees is more than that of the growth of the tree species. So forest cover is declining due to deforestation. It is due to urbanization, industrialization, mining activities, developmental activities. So there is a need to revive the forest cover, because there are many harmful effects of deforestation. Then question number 4, describe the use and overutilization of the surface and underground water. So we can understand in the beginning, we can write what is the basic necessity of life. It plays very important role. It is having number of uses. It is used for drinking. It is used for irrigation. It is used for agriculture, for rearing fishes, used for disposal of industrial waste. Waterways are used for the inland transport, but overutilization is more important. So rising demand for the water due to the increasing population is leading to the over-exploitation of the surface and underground water. Due to the shortage of surface water or the underground water, there can be possibility of the water world war also. So this overutilization is leading to number of conflicts at the national level, international level, even at the local levels also. So that is the reason overutilization of the surface water must be checked. Then describe the world food problems. There are many world food problems we have learned in the food resources. These world problems are, number 1, that is less production of the food, which is leading to the food crisis. But no doubt these food resources, they are having, besides this, problem of undernourishment, problem of malnutrition, problem of non-vegetarian food habits. You have to mention in detail that world food problems, they are due to loss. It is leading to loss of genetic diversity also, hoarding and black marketing too. All these steps has to be taken into mind while discussing the food problems. So the lastly, we are having descriptive questions. Describe the various types of renewable and non-renewable resources of energy along with advantages and disadvantages of each resource. Here we will mention in the beginning energy resources. Then there are mainly of two types, renewable, non-renewable. As we have discussed earlier, that renewable energy resources are those resources which can be regenerated again and again with the passage of time, while non-renewable resources of energy, they cannot be replenished immediately. They cannot be regenerated. So in the renewable, we will discuss in detail hydroelectric power, solar energy, biomass energy, wind energy, ocean energy, tidal energy, etc. Whereas in the non-renewable energy, we will discuss in detail coal, oil, and natural gas along with advantages and limitation or disadvantages of each resource. Then the last question is, describe the role of an individual in the conservation of natural resources. Each individual can play a very, very important role in the conservation of natural resources. So you can almost summarize the whole chapter in this answer. So firstly, we will write the term conservation means efficient use of natural resources. So firstly, we can categorize forest resources. We can explain it do's and do nots to conserve the forest resources. So there is continuous decline in the forest cover due to increasing demand of the wood and wood products in the society. Each individual can play a very important role by adopting following do's and do nots. In the do's, you can mention grow more and more trees, use less paper and paper products, use recycled paper, use email for the correspondence, use plastic furniture, repair wooden furniture wherever possible. Then in do nots, we can mention do not cut down the trees, do not use teak furniture, do not smoke near the forest, do not waste paper. So every individual can contribute to conserve the forest resources by adopting some do's and do nots. Similarly, for the water resources, we can say adopt rain water harvesting, use bucket to take the bath, use sprinklers for the irrigating lawns, use hand pumps, adopt rain water harvesting, save every drop of water, repair the taps immediately to avoid the leakage of water. What not to do? Do not take bath and wash clothes in the water bodies. Do not throw garbage into the water bodies. Do not waste fresh water for washing roads and floors. Do not use fresh drinking water for cleaning of the vehicles. So do not allow the wastage of the water. Similarly, for the energy resources also, each individual can adopt some do's. It means switch off the fans and lights when not in use, use CFL, use LED for the lighting, use solar cookers for cooking wherever possible, switch off the engine of the vehicle before the red light, use public transport, do carpooling, use renewable resources of energy. What not to do? Do not use electric bulbs, do not use individual vehicles for the, do not use individual vehicles for this transport. Do not cook the food in ordinary vessels. Do not cook the food without a lid. So lot of energy resources can be saved by every individual by such means. Then food resources, we use biofertilizers, use biopesticides, adopt vegetarian food habits, adopt crop rotation, adopt crop diversification, do mixed cropping and multiple cropping to save the food resources. Do not use chemical fertilizers, do not waste food, do not leave your food in plate, especially in marriages and functions. So what I mean to say is, every individual can play a wonderful role. So sustainable use of all the natural resources can be mentioned. Dear students, I hope so. You must have learned a lot that we can save natural resources to great extent. So every individual can play a very, very important role to conserve the natural resources, because natural resources are the gift of mankind. We should conserve it like a beautiful gift, because air, soil, water, we cannot think life without them. Hence, it is the duty of every individual to save the or to conserve the natural resources. I hope so you like this video. Thank you very much. In future also, you commit or you take the pledge to conserve the natural resources by adopting certain do's and do nots. So dear students, kindly share and subscribe with your friends also. Thank you very much.